Duplicate content. Have you ever heard of that? Or maybe an SEO nerd talked to you about duplicate content? Today we're going to talk about how do I make sure that I'm writing unique content and can I repurpose it effectively and not get in trouble with Google? When we talk about the Google algorithm, there's a lot of misunderstanding, mystery, smoke and mirrors, snake oil, whatever you want to call it, around what that really means. Everyone has their own interpretation of what that means. However, if we think about Google as just trying to find the experts that are most relevant and create unique content being the underlined bolded phrase, unique and relevant. Unique meaning there's no other copies of that same content anywhere on the internet. So what happens is when you release a piece of content, that content is timestamped, date and timestamped. Google's know when that was live, when it was indexed, and how long it's been online. Now, if we look at, if I take that from somebody else and I put it on my website, immediately Google can tell that we took it from this timestamp and put it on our website. So how do we prevent this from happening when we're hiring bloggers, we're hiring content writers? How do you make sure that the copy that you're purchasing hasn't been taken from someone else's website? There's a wonderful tool, as you can see in front of me here on my computer, called Copyscape. Now, Copyscape will help you to check the work you're getting from writers, pop it in here, and then see if you have any content that is plagiarized. Now, Copyscape.com is also used by college professors, high school teachers, to make sure that the content they're getting from their students has not been ripped off from any third-party locations. Very important. So if I come in here, I'm just gonna put my website in here. Let's see if anyone's taken my stuff. So it takes a minute for it to get going. So that's good, there's no results. That's always a good thing. But what you wanna make sure is that you are watching and monitoring anyone who uses your name. So I'm also gonna put in my book, because this will be interesting. When I published my book, Marketing Espionage, I thought I was gonna be able to carefully monitor and track it so that I knew if anyone took it, anyone did anything with it. It certainly can be easily taken because it's on Google, it's on Amazon, you can download the ebook copy versions, and I give most of it away. So one of my mentors and sort of the godfather of SEO is Bruce Clay. He has a wonderful training that I go to every year. It's a week of super nerd town, and it's definitely not the people I typically hang out with. Very quiet group at lunch. Usually I'm used to da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. But these are all the guys that really do the hardcore technical SEO. So Bruce Clay has a lot of following on the internet, and people definitely refer to him and quote him a lot. So if you look right here, I've done a Copyscape search for bruceclay.com. What you're seeing here is that they were able to find a number of different references to him. Now I'm gonna go ahead and click on this first one because that's where they found the SEO content. And you'll see now it goes back to his website, and everything is right there for me to find. So it's important that you also set up Copyscape has alerts. So if you'll come right down here, want a Copyscape alert. So you hit Copyscape, then you can sign up and you'll get plagiarism alerts. So what I would recommend is that you put all your content from some asset. You could put your entire book in there if you wanted to. You could put each chapter of a book, a white paper, a research document, whatever that might be. Set up the alert, and then you're going to get notified if anyone else takes it and uses it somewhere else. Now, another way to check for duplicate content is to go to Google Alerts. So google.com/alerts. So the thing about alerts is that it's very easy to watch and monitor what other people take. Really easy tip is to copy a section of content off your homepage. Put it into quotes into a Google Alert. So let me show you how that's done. I'm gonna go to my website. I'm gonna grab a piece of content. So I'm just gonna grab this section right here and I'm gonna copy it. Then I'm gonna go back to the Google Alerts. I'm gonna put quotes right there. I'm gonna then insert that copy and then put end quote. Now what's gonna happen, you'll see instantly that it sees that on my page. Now I'm going to set that up as an alert. So if anyone scrapes my website, takes the site, which has happened a number of times, strangely, Also, my name on Facebook has been taken a number of times, including pictures of my children and all kinds of things like that. The Google alert notified me, and then I knew immediately to call Facebook and have that account pulled down. It's out of Switzerland. It was very random. Anyway, a big part of having exposure and increasing your findability on the internet means you're more likely to be plagiarized, taken, or copied. So we want to keep our ear to the ground. We want to make sure we know what people are saying about our brand. And if someone rips off our content, we definitely want to be the first to know. If you want to dig deeper into the kind of things like Google Alerts or keyword research, check out my book, Marketing Espionage, How to Spy on Yourself, Your Prospects, and Your Competitors to Dominate Online. It's available at Amazon, as well as my other two books, Findability Formula and Thumbonomics. Check it out. Send me an email at heather@findability.com. Let me know if you'd like a copy of my ebook, and we'll get one over to you right away. There's also a link in the description below, and you can click on that and get the ebook copy as my gift to you.